with me, I'm Dipavli Hazra. These are the headlines at the top of 6. Jammu and Kashmir police have seized a truck carrying ammunition in Kathua and three people affiliated to the Jaish-e-Mohammed have been arrested. Meanwhile, there are reports of a large-scale build-up of militants across the line of control and the international border. Many infiltration attempts are also being reported to the army. Pakistan said today that his second consular access will not be granted to former Indian Navy officer Kulbhushan Jadhav. The MEA responded that India will ensure that the ICJ order is fully implemented and said it will keep diplomatic channels open with Pakistan. The Indian Deputy High Commissioner to Pakistan had met Jadhav on September the 2nd, but in the presence of Pakistani officials. India had asked for an unhindered access. Prime Minister Modi today launched pension schemes in poll-bound Jharkhand. He also inaugurated a new Jharkhand Vidhan Sabha premises. Addressing a rally, he said that his government is working on teaching economic offenders a lesson. In a clear dig at Congress leader P. Chidambaram, Prime Minister Modi said that some people who looted India are already behind bars. Interim Congress President Sonia Gandhi today chaired a mega meeting of the Congress called to formulate a strategy for the party's revival. In a scathing attack on the centre, Sonia said that it was not enough to formulate policies on social media. In other big decisions, the Congress has decided to appoint prereqs or foot soldiers at the district level across India. The Jamiat Ulema-e-Hind, the largest Muslim body in India, has backed the government's decision to abrogate Article 370 in a resolution passed today. The body stressed that Kashmir is an integral part of India and all Kashmiris are our compatriots. It also called out Pakistan for trying to project that Indian Muslims are anti-India. The body asserted that they are strongly with the country. Pakistan Minister Ijaz Ahmed Shah said in a television interview that the ruling elite, including Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan, had destroyed the image of the country. He said that the world believes India but does not take Pakistan as a serious nation despite its numerous objections to the abrogation of Article 370 by India. The Defence Research and Development Organisation on Wednesday successfully test-fired the man-portable anti-tank guided missile. This was the third successful test-firing of the 100% indigenous ATGM which will be used by the Army against enemy tanks and other armoured vehicles during wartime. According to Sports Ministry sources, boxer MC Mary Kom has been nominated for the Padma Vibhushan, making it the first time that a woman athlete's name has been forwarded for the second highest civilian honour in the country. Shuttler PV Sindhu has been recommended for the Padma Bhushan and wrestler Vinesh Fogart, table tennis player Manika Batra and cricketer Harmanpreet Kaur have been nominated for the Padma Shri. That's all for now. Stay tuned for more updates. We'll be right back.